Welcome back to the Ballerina Farm Kitchen. Today we're going to be making homemade mozzarella. I'm going to show you what you need if you want to make mozzarella at home as well. So we're starting with 1 gallon of milk. As you know, we have milk cows here at the farm, so this is raw, unpasteurized milk. You don't have to use raw milk though. You can buy milk from the store. Try to avoid ultra-pasteurized because I have never used that in cheese making, so I'm not sure how that would react. But yeah, we've got 1 gallon of milk. We have a pan. Something to stir. Important is a thermometer. And then we are going to add in a little bit of citric acid and animal rennet. And then I also like to have rubber gloves and some salt as well. So those are all the things that we need for making mozzarella. So we're just gonna jump right in. Here we go. You can make mozzarella with skimmed milk, but sometimes I use whole milk. Obviously you can see the cream line right here. I'm just gonna pour it all in. It's gonna be a full fat mozzarella, which is really luxurious and delicious. I'm gonna throw this in. Do you wanna go grab Maves? Hi, Mabel. Don't mind my sink full of dishes. This is just real life over here. Hello, Mabel. I thought you were milking the cow with Daddy-O. No? Okay, so we're gonna take the milk and we're going to heat it up to 55 degrees. Do you want me to hold you? Your shoes? Okay. Fran, will you bring over that thermometer really fast? And 55 degrees comes very quickly. We're already at 60. We're gonna take this out, okay. So yeah, honestly, like, I don't even know if I needed to put that on the stove. Like, I think it was 55 degrees. So, okay, now we are going to add 1/2 cup of water. Put this in here. Now we're gonna do 1 1/2 teaspoons of citric acid. And you can usually find this at your grocery store in the canning section, is where this is. This is 1 1/2. Now we're just gonna stir that until it's dissolved. So you can't see the white powder anymore. Try to get these specks out of here. Okay, don't drink that, Mabel. That's not water. Yeah. So now we're gonna add this citric acid and water. And we're just gonna stir in an up and down motion as we pour that in. Let's mix. You don't wanna over stir mozzarella because it will disrupt with the formation of the curds. So we're gonna take this over to the stovetop. And now we're gonna heat it up to 88 degrees. Grab the thermometer here. Gonna do up and down motion occasionally. We're already at 70 degrees. You can see this part goes fairly quickly.
Spaghetti?
Spaghetti?
No.
That does sound good. Like, I don't know how cheesemakers did it without a thermometer because it's so finicky, the temperature. Like, if you go above certain degrees while cheese making or below and you add your rennet or whatever at the wrong temperature, it doesn't turn out. So I'm so curious to know what they did before they had thermometers. They were much more in tune, I guess, with the process. But I have made mozzarella many, 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 many times. And the majority of the time it works out, but sometimes it doesn't. If you are using fresh milk, you don't want to use the day of milk. You want to use milk that's been refrigerated at least 24 hours. So I've made that mistake a few times. Okay, 88 degrees. Here we go. I've also forgotten about it after the rennet and waited too long before I cut the curds. There's been a few things I've done that, like, if you're not pretty exact, then your cheese won't work out. It's just a very hands-on. It takes about 40 minutes from start to finish. Oh, thank you, honey. Thank you. Mabel's giving me the salt. Okay, come sit here. Okay, so now we're going to add the rennet. So this is animal rennet. I bought this from New England Cheesemaking Supply. Rennet is the lining of a calf's stomach. So we're going to do half a teaspoon rennet with 4 tablespoons water.
One,
two, three, four. Thank you. Okay, so now we're going to add this in here. Okay, so we added the rennet. Now we're going to put this back on the stovetop until it reaches 105 degrees. Hold on, Mabel. Mabel, she's like covered in citric acid, and we'll see if this turns out. Okay, where's the thermometer? So now we're going to cover this for about 5 to 10 minutes until the curds have solidified. Hopefully we didn't get the milk too hot just now. Because if it does get too hot, it usually doesn't turn out. That nothing goes to waste on the farm. If it doesn't turn out, Fran, the pigs will drink it, or the chickens, or someone. Someone will eat it. Hang tight, everybody. So I'm just getting a bowl of cold water. So after the cheese is finished, you put the ball of cheese into the cold water, and that's how you store it for ultimate freshness. Oh, don't blame that, Martha. No. Don't blame that. Yeah, so I wanted, a note. There's so many variables with making cheese. It's temperatures, what kind of rennet you're using, how old the milk is, how much cream it is, whether it's skim or whether it's whole milk. So all these things play a part. Don't give up after the first time. Keep trying, because you'll kind of figure it out. And it's really, really fun to make and very satisfying.
What is it?
Okay, we're going to see the moment of truth, how things are coming along. What do you think, Miss Mabel May? I don't know how those are looking or not. I don't know. Okay, we're just going to kind of cut this up a little bit and see. Break this up.
Cheese?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It smells good.
Mm-hmm. So you can kind of show them how it looks right now.
Smell it.
Yeah. Okay, so now we're going to take this back over. Well, first we're going to add some salt. I like to add like 1/4 cup of salt to the whey.
Mabel, no.
Do about that much, and we'll just sprinkle that in here. You hold this for me. Okay, we're gonna take this back over here. Okay.
No.
This is where things get a little hot.
Uh-oh.
Start to sweat. We're gonna heat the whey up with the cheese. Let me grab my gloves.
Okay, that's good.
So you want the water to be very, very hot, but not boiling. So first step is just to shape it, into balls. Here comes Mabel. Mabel doesn't want to miss the action.
Yeah. She's like, oh, I'm gonna miss it.
Oh, but it's looking good, you guys. It's looking good. So it looks like we have about 3 balls of cheese from that gallon of milk. Thank you, honey. Here, you hold this. Okay, now we're gonna heat it up. Whew, I'm already kind of getting warm. The Aga, this stove is... she omits some heat. Yeah, she's warm. This plate is about 600 degrees. So when it's open, it's very warm. So I'm just gonna start to break apart from the middle the balls and just form the ball kind of inside out again. I'm just gonna start working the cheese just a little bit. So we'll grab one of the balls, kind of break it open, and then fold it back on itself, and then put it back in the water as it heats up.
Why?
Because we got to get it ready for stretching. Do it again. It's not quite hot enough to burn me yet. Daddy.
Daddy. Daddy.
Now we're checking along.
Get your first little thing out.
This was yesterday's milk that you milked, so good job.
Here's today's milk.
Good.
Daddy.
Daddy. Okay, starting to get a little warmer.
Feel me.
And then I'll start to see like, okay, yeah, it's probably ready to stretch it a little bit, but we're not quite there. So when, like you can see a little bit, they're getting a little bit more. They're getting hotter. They're getting able to stretch a little more. Depending on your stove, like I only have the hot stove and the simmering plate, so I put it on the hotter, and so it goes fairly quickly. This is about 10 minutes of kind of stretching the cheese.
Good.
We'll start to see
I love
the
tea. No, mozzarella.
Okay, it's getting really hot, so I'm gonna take this off for just a second. You just want to stretch in the beginning until it starts to break. And then you'll kind of reform it into a ball again. And then place it back into the salted whey. Stretching a little bit more. Back into a ball. Very good there. Hot, 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 hot. Stretch here. I told the kids that once it got really snowy, the baby would come. So that's where that comes from.
So you can have your baby.
Yes.
It's going to be a car. We don't know. Mommy, we don't know what it is, right?
We don't.
Can it be a surprise?
It is. Hi.
Hot, hot, hot.
Some.
Yes, we will in just a second.
No, don't.
Okay, like this is looking good to me. Like the texture is smooth. It's stretching. So I think I'll form these into balls with like one more stretch. And then that's it. Ooh, hot, hot, hot. Just gonna tuck everything in there, form it into a little ball. Because the cheese is warm, you can put it into a ball and it kind of stays put. So that's kind of what it's gonna look like. Do you wanna go get that bowl of water for me? Go get that for me. And then we will place the cheese balls into the cold water. Fran's bringing it over. Perfect. Thank you. Here we go. So this is the first ball of cheese. So yummy. One more little shape here. Just kind of tucking all the ends in. Mozzarella doesn't last super long at our house, so
why is it cold?
We don't have to be perfect. But you can freeze mozzarella. You can shred it and freeze it. You can freeze it in the balls. So if you want to stock up for pizza night or whatever you're making it for. Okay, so here we go.
Can I have the juice?
We will try the cheese. Should we eat some fresh cheese, girls?
Yeah, me first.
Okay, we'll slice up some apples so that it can. Oops, we have cheese and apples. Okay, Mabel, do you want to sit in your high chair? Okay, right here. Oh, this is Mabel Mace. So here we go. We'll slice some of this. Everyone's going to get some. So whoever's the most patient.
Me.
Oh, we got to be patient. Okay, here we go. So we'll take one of these out. Just going to slice it. Here. We like to drizzle just a tiny bit of French salt on the top. I'll just try without the apple. Okay. I'm the most patient, I guess, so I'll go first. Here you go, Martha. So good. Sprinkle a little bit more salt.
May I have three? Mm-hmm.
There you go. Try some. Now remember, we have to close our mouth when we eat. Okay, so as you can see, it's not super complicated, but also kind of complicated. You just have to be pretty precise with the steps and the temperatures. But it's really fun to make. Less than an hour, you can have fresh mozzarella for your pizzas or just to eat plain like we do. So try it. Let me know how it goes. And that's all for today. Thanks for joining. Did you take the whole ball? Martha Lou. These kids are savages. We're actually going to jump in the car. We're going to run to Colville.